Hello students, from the chapter quadratic equations, let's solve exercise 10.2 in this video. For first problem, fourth subdivision, 2x square minus x plus 1 by 8 equal to 0. So in this given equation, we see a fraction 1 by 8. So in order to remove that fraction, we are going to multiply the whole equation by 8. Okay. So, once it is multiplied, so you will get 2 into 8 is 16x square, then minus 1. So, minus 1 into 8 is minus 8 and 1 by 8 into 8. So, 8 and 8 will get cancelled and we will be left with plus 1. Okay. Then next step, we have to split the middle term. So, for splitting the middle term, we should get two number whose sum is equal to minus 8. So, that is a middle term. And its product should be equal to 16. 16 how we got? Because here, these two coefficient. 16 into 1. Okay. So, that is 16. So, that we should get as the product of the two numbers. So, which will give that? So, by seeing the ones place, we can guess the number. Okay, here it is 6. What and all when multiplied? What are the factors when multiplied gives 6 in the ones place? So, you have to check like that. So, if we check 4 into 4, it is product is 16. But 4 plus 4 is equal to 8. Okay, and we should get minus 8. So, what we are going to do? We are going to put minus sign for both the factors. So, minus 4 into minus 4 is 16 plus 16. Okay, because both are minus, when you multiply, you will get 16. And if you add those two numbers together, you will get minus 8. So, those minus 4 and minus 4 are the factors which we get here. So, the middle term, minus 8 is split and written as minus 4x minus 4x. Okay, so we have to take out the common. So, here in these two terms, we see 4x as common. So, take out 4x outside the bracket and inside the bracket, we have 4x minus 1. Okay. Then similarly, here only minus 1 can be taken out. Okay. We have to make sure that both the brackets are equal also. 4x minus 1 we should get in both the brackets. Okay. Then now take out 4x minus 1 as common outside. So, you will get one more bracket, that is 4x minus 1. So, these two are the factors. Okay. So, the roots of this equation are the values of x for which 4x minus 1 into 4x minus 1 equal to 0. Okay. So, both the terms are same only. Okay. So, equate it to 0. So, after equating, I am getting x is equal to 1 by 4 and 1 by 4. Both the roots are equal. That's it. So, we see that both the roots of the equations are equal, 1 by 4. Then next equation, 100x square minus 20x plus 1 equal to 0. Okay. So, similarly, we have to start with the factorizing the, using the splitting of middle terms. Okay. So, here we need sum of the two numbers equal to minus 20. And product of those two numbers should be equal to 100 into 1. Okay. So, that is 100. Okay. So, by seeing this number. So, we are having a 0 in the ones place. So, we can by trial and error method only. So, which number when multiplied will give you 0 in the ones place. So, 10 into 10 will give you 100. But sum of the two numbers is equal to plus 20. Okay. We want minus 20. So, change the sign of those two numbers. So, if you multiply, you will get 100. And if you add, you will get minus 20. So, split the middle term and write it as minus 10x minus 10x. Okay. Now, take out common. So, here we see 10x as common for these two terms. So, take out 10x outside the bracket. So, inside the bracket, we will have 10x minus 1. Okay. Then, we have to get the same term inside the bracket. Both the brackets should be equal. So, you have to take out such that. So, we are taking out minus 1. Okay. Then, equate it to the 0. So, these two are the factors. So, equate it to 0. So, that we will get the roots of the equation. So we can equate it to 0. So both are same only. So equate it to 0. So we will get 1 by 10. Okay. So the roots are equal. 1 by 10, 1 by 10 is the roots of the equation. Second problem. Represent the following situations mathematically. John and Jivanti together have 45 marbles. Both of them lost 5 marbles each. And the product of the number of marbles they now have is 124. We would like to find out how many marbles they had to start with. Okay. So, it's a word problem. You have to read the question carefully. So, together they had 45 marbles. And both of them lost 5 marbles each. Both of them lost. Okay. And product of the number of marbles now it is 124. Okay. So, with this we have to find out how many marbles they had. So let us take the number of marbles John have be X. Okay. So the one more number of marbles Jivanti can be 45 minus X. Because total of those two person marbles is 45. No. So you can write in that way it is 45 minus X. Okay. So after losing 5 marbles each. So John will be having x minus 5 and Jivanti will be having 45 minus x minus 5. Okay. So, both these two numbers you can simplify. No? So, 45 minus 5 is 40. So, 40 minus x now Jivanti is having. Given that the product of their marble is 124. Okay. So, write that in terms of the x. Okay, so x minus 5 into 40 minus x equal to 124. Okay, so now simplify, remove the brackets. So you will get x square minus 45x plus this one. So this constant also I am bringing to the LHS, that's why I am getting 324. Okay, after simplifying I am getting this equation. So, after this what we should do? We have to find out the value of x. Then only we will get the number of marbles both the person were having. Okay. So, in order to find out x, we are going to factorize by using the splitting the middle term. Then we will find the root. Okay. So, that's how we have to solve this problem. So, for splitting the middle term, we want two numbers whose sum is equal to minus 45. And product should be equal to 124. 1 into 324. Okay. So, that is equal to 324 only. Okay. So, now we see that the last number is 4. Okay. So, with that trial and error method only we have to find out. So, which number when multiplied, which two numbers when multiplied will give you 4 in the ones place. Okay. So, one by one we have to try. So, after trial and error method, we found that minus 9 and minus 36 will satisfy both the condition. Okay. So, when added, we will get minus 45 and product will be equal to 324. Okay. So, these two are the numbers which satisfy the condition. Okay. So, we can split and write like this. Then take out common. So, in these two terms, x is common. Take out outside. So, x into x is x square and x into minus 36 is minus 36. Okay. Same way here also 9 is common. So, 9 you take it as outside. So, put the minus sign. Then only the brackets will be equal. So, x minus 36 will be inside the bracket. So, that is taken out common. Then we will have x minus 9 equal to 0. So, we have to equate it to 0. Okay. So, x minus 36 is equal to 0 or x minus 9 equal to 0. Okay. After taking the constant to the RHS, we got x is equal to 36 or x is equal to 9. So, if John's marbles is 36, okay, x is 36, no. So, whose variable we gave x? It is John's. Okay, John marble, number of marble is 36 means, then Jivanti's marble is 45 minus x. That is 45 minus 36 equal to 9. okay, this is one condition. And one more is, if John's marble is 9, here we are having x is equal to 36 or 9. Okay, so both are in positive. So, anything can be the number of marbles of John. Okay, so substitute both the values. So, now we are substituting x is equal to 9. So, Jeevanti's number of marbles will be 45 minus 9 equal to 36. Okay, that's the answer. A cottage industry produces a certain number of toys in a day. The cost of production of each toy in rupees is found to be 55 minus the number of toys produced in a day. On a particular day, the total cost of production is 750. We would like to find out the number of toys produced on that day. Okay. So what and all it is given, a cost of production of each toy is found to be 50 minus the number of toys. Okay. So let's take number of toys as X. Okay. So the production cost of each toy. So each toy is going to be X minus 50. Okay. So be careful, because here it is given each toy. Okay. So that's why it is 50 minus X. Then total cost production is 750. Totally how much money is spent means for the production is 750 rupees. So if the number of toys is X, means then one toy production cost is this much, 50 minus X. So together if you multiply, you will get the total cost production. Okay, this is for one toy. Okay, so X toys they are producing. So X into this money, if you multiply, it's a total cost production. That is equal to 750. So now remove the brackets. So simplifying, you will get x square minus 55x plus 750 equal to 0. This equation we will get. So we have to find out the value of x. We have to split the middle terms. So the condition is sum should be equal to minus 55 and the product of the two numbers should be equal to 750. Okay. So, which two factors when multiplied, we will get 0 in the ones place. Like that you have to check. Okay. So, after trial and error method only. So, one by one you should try. So, after trying, I got minus 30 and minus 25. So, these two numbers when added, I will get minus 55 and product is 750. So, these two numbers I am substituting in the middle term. So, after that, take out common from the first two terms. So here x is common, so taken out x. So x minus 25 will be inside the bracket, and here 30 is common, so take out 30. Okay, so take out minus sign also. So inside the bracket I'll get x minus 25 equal to 0. So our factors are x minus 25 into x into sorry x minus 30. Now equate it to 0. So, after equating to 0, I am getting x is equal to 25 or 30. Okay. So, hence the number of toys produced in a day will be either 25 or 30. Okay. So, this is the number of toys produced in a day. Okay. So, with this, I will wind up this video. I will continue the remaining problems of this exercise in my next video. Thank you, children.